Good morning children, welcome to the class. Okay, in previous section I have given you some work, so to write to question them. Yes, to see their answer I have given, and I have told you to write the question. Okay, see, I'll ask three questions from them. First one, whom did Ravi approach first? Whom did Ravi approach first? Yes, very good. Teacher. Okay? Ravi approached teacher first. Who was he asked to meet next? Okay, what teacher told to him after approaching the teacher? Teacher told him to ask permission, meet some primary coordinator. Very good. And now, coordinator. Very good. Who took the final decision regarding Ravi's request? Who took the final request? Final decision? Yes, very good. Principal took the final decision. Now listen. First, Ravi spoke to his teacher. First, Ravi, he speak with his teacher. Next, then he met the primary coordinator. Then who he met? He met primary coordinator. Who asked him to write a letter to the principal? Okay, primary coordinator told him to write a letter to principal sir. The principal allowed him to take the exam on a later day. Okay, what principal told him? The principal principal accepted the letter and he told him to write the exam the next day. Okay, first he used to participate in quiz and again he used to write exam. Okay, see. Just like Ravi's school, every organization has different levels at which decisions are taken. Okay, same as Ravi's school. In Ravi's school, what happened? He selected in a quiz competition and as well as he has the exam on the same day. And first he met his teacher and teacher told to meet primary coordinator. Primary coordinator told to write a letter to principal. Then principal agreed to participate in quiz and write the exam next day. Okay, same as like that, we are also having some, so in every organization, there are some different levels to take decisions like this. Okay, our government also has same like this, works at different levels to ensure the welfare of its people. Okay, our government also, they have different sectors and different people to take decisions in different type of problems. So, the different types of organizations will take care of people. Okay? It is formed by the people of our country. See, this government is formed by the people of our country. People who form the government are called representatives of the government. Okay, people who form the government are called representatives. Okay, they represent from our side to government. Okay, these are representatives. They are called representatives. Okay, next. These representatives are chosen by the people through the process of voting. Okay, how these representatives are chosen? They are chosen by the people, means us. They are chosen by us by the process of voting. Voting means elections. Elections will held and we will elect the representative from our side. Okay. The government in India has the following structure. Okay, the government of India is also having same structure. They follow this structure. See, first one, national or central government. okay, national or central government means government or government, central government. It is the head. The central government is head. The central government takes care of the entire country. Okay, the central government takes care of entire country means our India full. Taken care by our central government. Okay, Union territories are governed directly by the central government. Okay, in our country we have 28 states and 8 union territories. So these union territories are governed by central government only. Okay, state government. The country is divided into many states so that various tasks can be carried out to meet the needs of people. Okay, our countries are divided into many states, and what happened? So various tasks, so various things, various works are carried out by the government to meet this, to fulfill the needs of the people. Okay, fulfill the needs of the people. Each state has its own government called the state government. Okay, this country is divided into so many states, and each state has government. So this government is called state government. Each state has several cities, towns and villages. It also has a capital. Okay, each state has several cities, towns and villages, and each state has its own capital. Okay, each state has its own capital. The state government carry out their roles. The state government carry out their roles, roles in their respective states based on the rules and regulations set by the central government. Okay, this what happened? The state government has some roles, so which are set by the respective basis on rules and regulations. Our state governments has some rules and regulations which are set by central government. Okay. Local government. Towns and villages have a local government that provides them various services. Okay. A country is divided into states. Some cities, towns, villages. These all make a state. Okay, and these villages and towns have their local government also. So local people or local leaders take care of this people. So that is called local government. Okay, children, this is the class for you today. Okay, tomorrow we will meet in the next section. Okay, bye.